Good morning, everyone. My name is David Chartrand. I'm the president of the Metis Federation. And on behalf of the cabinet, I want to thank everybody that's listening at home and around the world. My message today is very straightforward. Firstly, I want to thank every citizen that's taking the message loud and clear from the Prime Minister and from Canada that we need to isolate. We need to help each other. We need to unify. We need to work together on this crisis and this pandemic that's affecting the world. This is something we have to take seriously. I want to take this opportunity to thank the Prime Minister and clearly make a message to his cabinet, thanking them for including the Métis Nation as part of the strategy. I think it's essential. We understand that very clearly. We were very somewhat disappointed in the first announcements that were coming out. It was only for First Nation, but we've been able to correct that. The Prime Minister has assured us that the Métis Nation will not be forgotten and this thing base is still his priority. So again, I want to thank the Prime Minister, but I also want to thank him on the way Canada is reacting to this. A very solid, unified voice for all Canadians, including the Métis Nation. Our government is doing the same. We've commenced action in our government, where our cabinet is at several emergency meetings, our management are meeting on a regular basis, and we're looking at number one issue, the safety of our citizens. We want to make sure our staff, our management, and our citizens are both safe. At the same time, how do we continue delivering services? How do we make sure the services we provide to you are ongoing at the same time for safety on your side and our side? So it's important that management continues to move forward on this, and I want to again express my gratitude on behalf of Cabinet and as the President, all staff and management are working so hard on this trying time. There's a lot of stress out there. People feel it. You can see it. People are panicking. People are scared, and they have a right to be scared. This is a serious issue, and we need to be very astute to it, and we need to be ready for it, and we need to do everything we can. Your government is looking at it from the context of how do we make sure we take action. Minister Francis Chartrand, who's Minister of Health for the Métis government, is taking some extreme measures to make sure that we're taking action to help our citizens all across Manitoba. We're looking at every venue that we can, turning every rock that we can, and ensuring that we can find ways to help our people. I'll give you a few instances where we have already commenced this action. We have now moved forward on an action for mobile homes if necessary, if it takes off in community after community after community. It gets into a massive pandemic. We also now, under Jack Park's leadership, we are moving forward to open 248-bed facilities in Treherne. These construction camps that we had are now turning into health facilities. To make sure that we have all the proper facilities and tools and equipment we would need to make sure we protect our people. So those camps are being developed as we speak and being prepared. So there's 96 beds there in total that we can use. And if we don't use them as the Métis government, as Métis citizens, then the province of Manitoba, if they find that they are in need, we'll be there to help all Manitobans. So our Métis government is looking at it as an entire Manitoba issue, not just the Métis issue. I think we need to work together. All society needs to come together. The First Nation, the Métis, and the non-Indigenous people, we all need to hold hands and come together. And I take away the comment, hold hands, I mean come together supporting each other. Stay away from handshakes. Do the elbow thing, do the knuckle thing, or stay away and just do the nod. And I know it's hard in our culture. It's definitely hard in the way we do things. I'm a hugger, always been. And I don't only hug others, I've kissed throughout my life. And throw out the cheeks and the foreheads and all that has to stop right now, temporary. But we'll come back to our culture. Let's understand that. We'll come back to the ways of way we do things. So don't let that take away that our culture will change. Our culture will not change. We'll just temporarily have a different way of saying hello, a different way of saying that we care and admire each other. So let's put that into perspective and understand that from the culture side. But I also want to make an announcement today. I know there's panic out there. We've gotten calls already from employers that are wondering what's going to happen to me. My business is hurting already. I'm losing all my revenue. How do I pay? How do I make my bank payments? How do I actually make my mortgage payments for my company? How do I pay my employees? And we know for a fact that it's hurting. It's hurting around the world. It's hurting in every country in the world. It's just not just Canada's problem. It's the world's problem. But again, I want to take this opportunity to thank the Prime Minister again for his actions. He's announced $82 billion. And a large portion of it is going to go to employee situations like unemployment insurance. It are also increasing the child allowance money to every family, every child that's out there. There'll be different amounts awarded to each child. EI, they're changing the rules. Our team right now is working at the Federation to get all of those rules in place, understanding those rules. If you're laid off and you don't have enough hours, will you still be eligible? We're getting all the answers for you, and we're creating this 1-800 line, which you will see attached to Facebook ongoing in our website. So, but one of the things I want to announce today is that I know employees are also scared. When their employer is laying them off, and fishermen, for example, or they're saying they're shutting down the fishing industry. Those are tiny little businesses, one or two working in with one employer, and clearly those employers already are having a hard time making ends meet. How do they now supplement their employees? So we need an action plan on that. And Minister Pronto has already raised that with me, and we're putting something together to help our fishermen that are out there suffering and wondering how they're gonna feed their family when we're asking them to isolate, and how do they isolate if they don't have enough groceries in their cupboards for the children. So what we're doing at the Federation now is we're making a first time announcement of this sort. Again, I want to thank my cabinet and Anita Campbell, the Minister of Finance. I want to thank all those that are working behind the scenes to make life better and easier for you, or to try to accompany your needs. We are making an announcement today of $1 million cash that will be set aside for the entire Métis Nation. We're moving that as our first incentive over and above the tiny homes we're buying, over and above the already camp that we're building, over and above other programs and services that we're organizing outside of that. So this investment will be close to more to about $1.5 million to $1.6 million right off the top. So, but $1 million cash will be made available for our citizens all across our homeland in Manitoba. We're making it very clear to our employees, if your employer is not there to help you and can't, then contact MMF. And we'll try to give you enough money to carry yourself through the groceries until we maybe figure out the unemployment insurance issue, how you can access that or access other venues. So your government's gonna try its best. And the number one issue that we know is fundamental to all of us, it's in our bloodline, to our culture and to our people, is our elders. In fact, I wanna again thank the MCLT team in our government. I wanna thank Minister Chartrand again for this, the Minister of Health. We have already contacted 1,000 elders and in conversing with them to make sure they're okay. Now we're gonna be following up. Every region is gonna get in $25,000 cash immediately to make sure they have the resources and to hire people if necessary to go and deliver groceries to our seniors to keep them isolated in their homes. We do not want our elders going to towns to shop. We don't want our elders leaving their house. We want them staying in their house. They're the most vulnerable, and we need to understand that. We need to make sure we protect our elders. That's part of who we are. It's in our culture, it's in our bloodline, and we make sure we do it. So we are moving that action very quickly. That cash infusion will happen immediately. That's being announced today, that $1 million will be available. And we're telling everybody, please, if your employer is not assisting you and you need help, call us. We are not gonna give you thousands of dollars, but we'll give you enough to make sure you carry yourself through this tough time and getting the groceries, to make sure your children have food and you're safe, and you then can truly isolate yourself because you've got the support of your government. We're also moving forward on a straight component of helping those that are also isolating themselves. We're trying to figure out how do we help those that are isolating themselves. If they don't have enough income, if their income has been cut off, is there a situation where we find that people are finding themselves caught in a situation that they need to isolate but they don't have enough resources? We're trying to figure out how do we address that. You know, there's 120,000 Métis people in this province. For sure we can't give everybody $1,000, but we can do this. We can help those that need help, and those that can carry themselves, like my family and all the employees of the Federation, we know we can take care of ourselves. And all those that are working hard and all those strong business people out there that have money and families out there that are pretty assured that they have enough resources to secure themselves, probably through a 3-month is what they're talking about potential. There's a 3-month concern that's happening in this country. We need to worry about those 3 months. After that, they think it's gonna dip. That's his suggestion right now, it's not the fact. But that's what all the experts are telling everyone. There's potential 3-month isolation or even 1-month isolation, but let's take it at 3 months to be precaution. So let's figure out how we move forward. So our first investment is that $1 million of cash immediately. So we'll be working on that, and please give us an opportunity to also, if the floodgates come, people are already calling. People are already phoning in saying, I need help now. So we're trying to get ourselves organized and in place as quickly as we can also. But the good thing is, I know Canada's also gonna be helping us, but they can't move their system fast enough because they got 36 million people to worry about. So they will come to us eventually, but showing you the great vision of our cabinet, that in our tough times, the Métis government's been able to carry itself financially through different times, and this is a good example of that. So we're also working on wondering what's happening. We'll be sending out a press release this afternoon regarding those that are being in jails that are being released. Now, I have very strong concerns about that issue because you're releasing them to where? Some of them are being let go early, so they don't want to carry that burden in the institutions. But if they're being let go out of jails, we know for a fact they're not going to get a job. There are so many people being laid off as we speak right now. There's not a chance anywhere they're going to get a job. So how do they carry themselves? Is the government right now working to assure them that they have some assistance, maybe social assistance, just to carry them through these 3 months, make the exceptions necessary that we help these people coming out of jails throughout our province, whether it's federal, provincial corrections? We need to work closely in making sure when they leave those corrections, they're let out earlier, and that they have a place to stay. How are they going to isolate? How do we make sure they don't go back to gangs? How do we make sure that they can try to start building their lives? Our hope and our dream is that they all get a job, but we know there's no jobs. No jobs will be available to anybody. Air Canada's laid off 5,100 people just now. So it's happening right across the country. People are being laid off. Stores are starting to shut down. Stores are starting to turn their hours differently. And people are starting to panic. People are bulk buying. You can't blame them. They're struggling. They're worried. They want to protect their family. It's a natural instinct for us to protect our family. A natural instinct for the Métis government to protect its family. So again, I want to state very clearly, we are there to protect you. We're there to help you. We're there to go through this tough time together. We need to work together. Your cabinet and your staff are working very hard. Please show them respect. Don't get frustrated if they can't answer your question right away, because they're struggling too. They're trying to get all the answers from Canada. We have little answers right now from the province. We're hoping our connection with the Winnipeg Regional Health Authority will expand even further, that we can have ability to know exactly where the province is going and how it's going to actually impact or assist our people. We don't have those answers from the Minister of Health right now for the province, and I hope that'll come soon. But at the end of the day, your government's already ready. We're moving, and we're getting ready to make sure we do everything we can to assist you. Our pharmacy is still out there. Our pharmacy is still going to be delivering. Our free medicine is still going to be there. We're actually making exceptions to our pharmacy for more stuff. So keep in to our website. Look at our website, what's going on. And we're continuing to, in fact, we're developing a new app right now, a new app just for COVID. And that'll come into our website probably within the next few days. Again, I thank Minister Chartrand for that. And you'll be able to tap into that COVID, get updates, get what's going on. Watch, there's fraud out there happening, my friends. There's fraud taking place where people are taking advantage of this unbelievable, crucial, hard time we're facing as a world. And there are fraudsters out there trying to get information from you, saying that they're from a health institution, they need your information, share your information, share your social resource, share your address, share your numbers. Do not share anything. Look in the websites, go to MMF to see if they're authentic. Our staff, communication staff, are working very hard to put everything to that website. So we want to make sure you look at the MMF website, and we'll only put stuff that's accurate and real. So trust your Métis government, go into your Métis government, they'll be there to help you. So with that, I want to say everybody, thank you. I'm right now in isolation, I got a chest cold. I've been traveling, of course, everybody knows I was in Vancouver, Saskatoon, Ottawa, and I'm doing it not for my sake, really. I'm doing it for, I don't want to share if I do have something to have some of our innocent citizens that did not travel, and then I pass it on to them. So I'm waiting by next week, I should know. I haven't been tested yet. I'm waiting for, I think there's others that were traveling with me are being tested. So I'm hoping that they'll find out. I will go get tested in the next few days to find out. I hope that there's nothing, and I'm sure there's nothing. I just got a chest cold and head cold and running nose, but that's probably a flu. So let's understand, but I'm still in isolation. I'm working from home. I'm working diligently. I've had so much conference calls nationally and provincially. And as I said, we're working as unified government, and we want to make sure we protect our people. So I want to say this, as my mom has taught me and our elders have always taught us. I want to send my prayers to each and every one of you. I want to make sure that you're fully capable of understanding your government will be there. Don't panic. Don't be afraid. Get a hold of us. We may not have all your answers, but we'll do everything in our power to help you. So again, I thank you, and I thank the cabinet and our team and all of you at home that are listening, supporting, and working towards this tough time that the world is facing. It is a scary time, but if we work all together, I'm sure we'll be quite successful and we'll be able to do great things. So I pray, my prayers will go to every Métis citizens out there. And again, thank you for being who you are, a strong Métis nation. Thank you very much.